G'day guys, Ziggy D here. In this video, I just wanted to showcase some of the awesome energy shield gear crafting I did in Betrayal yesterday using the insanely powerful Delve Fossils. I did make a guide to the different ways you can figure out potent fossil crafting combos back in Delve League, and I'll link that video in the description below. Highly recommend checking it out because fossils are just so good at all levels of gameplay, whether you're someone just crafting some basic, cheap budget gear, some intermediate, decent endgame gear, or even some really insane combination crafting. Obviously, in this video, I get pretty good stream RNG. What would you expect out of a highlight like this? But energy shield builds have gotten a lot stronger and easier to produce gear for than ever before in Path of Exile's history. You have a ton of options besides fossils as well. Chaos spamming, essence crafting, and essences are super cheap right now, tiny trial crafting, insanely powerful master crafting with multi-modding, all in addition to those actual fossils. It really is the best league ever to try and craft yourself some gear, and the process is super fun. It's one of my favorite things in Path of Exile. So hopefully this video inspires you or gives you some ideas on crafting your own gear for your build. Enjoy. So we're gonna use this site, PoEDB, when we're looking for fossil crafting stuff. So we're gonna go to body armors and intelligence body armors. And then this has a pretty useful feature where you can see what will happen if you use certain fossils. So obviously we're gonna use a dense fossil, which gives more energy shield, but no life modifiers. So straight up, that'll cut away life. So that's pretty handy. Means we're much more likely to land the energy shield. They're also highlighted to mean they're more likely. But also there is increased energy shield delve suffix you can get as well. So we can get a bit of extra energy shield if we land the suffix and get lucky. So the thing we wanna look at though is to see whether there's anything else we could do that would be useful. So shattering fossil could be interesting. More speed, no mana modifiers. So that'll cut the mana prefix away and add chance to gain frenzy charge when hit. That's not super important, but removing the mana is potentially a useful thing. And I don't think the shuddering fossils are too expensive. I have a few. Perfect fossils. Perfect fossils specifically you use before doing other crafting. It improves the quality between 15 and 25, or is it 15 and 30%? This has 24 quality on it, and we could always use Hillock to add 28 quality instead. So I don't know if it's from between 15 and 30. I guess we could have a crack with it. We could do a perfect first and then see if we get lucky and land 30. Otherwise, we could always just use Hillock later, I suppose. So we'll just use a Chaotic Resonator. This will randomize the mods. So you want to do this first before you do any other crafting. I got 28, so that's fine by me. I think that's pretty decent. That's about the best. That's the best Hillock could give, I think. So that's fine. Yes. So I'm going to put these in there. Oh, maybe I should do them one at a time. All right. So we're hoping to get, you know, 550-ish, if we're lucky. But definitely like an open suffix would be nice so that I could keep the energy shield and focus suffix. Whoa. Okay, that'll do. That'll do. I got percentage up to, I got 91 up to percentage, and then we got landed a hybrid percentage and stun recovery and scintillating flat and a suffix. We also got a suffix as well. So we actually got the suffix. We got both of the fossil suffixes, the frenzy and the energy shield, and it has an open suffix. Shit. This might be worth divining. One of the percentages can go up a little bit. It's already at kind of the top end. The flat is kind of close to the top end. The hybrid is pretty low, and the increase can actually go between 25 and 50. Oh yeah, that's worth divining, because look at that last line there, the second last line, 25 to 50, and we landed 25, so actually a huge range on that. So that's definitely worth divining. So this might go up to 630, 640 or something with a decent divine. Let's have a look at belts. What would, so dense, make it more likely to get energy shield and armor. And it also adds energy shield from body armor mod, which is potentially pretty damn strong. These ones are not so good though. What does shuddering do on this? Anything? Tends to get an onslaught when you use a flask. Interesting. I guess I'll just use that anyway. I'll just YOLO that on one of my belts. I could just save it for later, which is my highest item level. They're pretty low item level to be honest, but YOLO. Burp. Oof, that's pretty good. 46 energy shield. Flask effect duration's a nice mod. And 13 energy shield from body armor. The last mod there is really nice. That's really nice. Unfortunately, it's got 3 suffixes, so I couldn't put a resist on it, but we can put a prefix on it. That's a pretty good build. Look at my fossil crafting. Oh my god, guys. My fossil crafting. Oh, yo, I can put hybrid energy shield on that? Shit, yeah. I didn't know you could do that. Reckon I should get the 3C flask effect, or like 16 to 20 ES and armor. Damage is 1x. Might be a lower roll. You can get 14 to 16 for 2C. Normally I'd go evasion ES, but since it's got the double armor thing, I might as well get the armor ES. We got 17. Let's roll that again. 20. Nice. All right, let's see if this is actually more ES than Bated Breath. Probably not still. Oh, it actually is. I made an upgrade from Bated Breath. Oh my god, I finally did it. And it's going to be better when this is on as well, because this has higher energy shield. I need a Divine. I'll trade you a Divine if you want. Yeah, I lose recovery speed from Bated Breath, but honestly, it's not that big a deal. I go from 5,300 to 4,400. New helmet crafting too, dense plus frigid. Yeah, we could actually potentially craft a helmet upgrade over our current helmet if we got like a hubris circlet and crafted dense plus frigid, because that can do minus cold res to nearby enemies and also a good energy shield. All right, let's see how we go off one divine here. Hoo-wee. So the other rolls are pretty decent mostly, but that suffix being 25 to 50 has a big range for improvement. So we're hoping for like, I don't know, 70 to 80th percent range of max of the other ones, and then hopefully pushing that bottom affix up as much as possible. Ooh, that's pretty good. 630 went up to 47. 86 of 91, 64, so the flat is a bit low. The percentages are all really good though. 47 out of 50. That's a keeper for sure. We could spend 100 divines and probably not get that up. Thanks for the winning divine, mate. That was a sexy divine. And I could craft quality if we really wanted to just push the energy shield as high as possible. I could craft quality to push it even higher. But I am just going to craft the healing effect because the heal is very nice. 23. Oh, wrong one. I crafted the wrong one. Whoops. Wasted 3 chaos. Well, I get good luck, but then I waste my money on other things. Where's the one that I want? This one. Here we go. Let's try that again. I'll push that up from 23. Try again. 24. 23. 23. 23. Jesus, rip alterations and scours. 25. There we go. Jeez. Let's have a look on PWDB again. Maybe we do just craft one. Maybe we do. Shields, int. So we can remove shattering to get rid of mana. We can use shattering again to get rid of mana. You could also do corroded and its opposite to block mods. Yeah, that's true. We could stack the nose together to block everything out. Maybe dense, corroded, and prismatic. Yeah, then block it. Then we kind of block it all out. That might be better. I'll check that. So the idea is to add some things together that block each other's things that they add. So in this case, Corroded has the no elemental mods, which is what we want, but it also adds poison and bleed mods that we don't care about. But we can use Metallic, which one is it? Is it Prismatic? More elemental mods, but no poison or bleeding mods. So that'll get rid of the poison and bleeds from the Corroded. It'll add elemental mods, but we're blocking those with Corroded anyway. So all of a sudden now the crafting list looks like this. Just energy shield, spell damage, which actually wouldn't be that bad to get. An energy shield suffix. Shall I YOLO Alkit for luck again? Terrible. Terrible. Alright. Oh, no, I need a 3 socket. Here we go. Alright. Whoa, boom! It got the suffix energy shield. With a prefix craft, that's a decent energy shield. I should probably just craft it and sell it. But it's not very good for me. To see how it landed the suffix energy shield, the 45. So that'll add to the percent prefix. So it looks bad like on first glance, but it's actually not a bad shield with this craft. If we land a decent number. 334. So I mean, that's still... I probably made back my money on that, maybe. Maybe I made a profit. We'll see how much it's worth. All right. Like Chris Wilson's beard, I bless these two things. May they join together in holy matrimony.
Oh, shit. We did it.
God damn, that's really good. That's really good. We landed the suffix. Prefix energy shield's a little low, but we got the hybrid as well as the flat. And it's got open suffix, which is exactly what I want. That is literally exactly what I want. Crafting is too easy for me. What the hell? How is this crafting going so well for me?
And you could just straight up add like extra quality as well, but I need the cold res, so we'll get that.
Oh man, how much energy shield do I have with all this up now? Hey, we crossed that 11k mark.
That 11k though.
Oh baby, that what a crafting session. So that's showing just some of the power of fossil crafting. And this isn't even getting into what you can do with fossils plus Shaper and Elder bases, which is insane. Because you can stack the specific fossil mods in addition to the Shaper and Elder mods, as well as like, as well as adding, you know, adding a more likely chance of getting those powerful Shaper and Elder mods too. Then, you know, working in with the new powerful Veiled mod crafting, it's just even better now. Oh my god.